Welcome to all families, staff, and most importantly, soon to be graduates of the class of 2020. Welcome. Before we officially begin, I would like you to join me in a moment of silence to acknowledge the context that we are currently in, specifically the victims of COVID-19 and of centuries of racial violence. For Breonna Taylor, Stephen Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, George Floyd, for far too many, I ask that you join me in a moment of silence to honor their lives. Thank you. Well, this is a little awkward, right? Nobody would have anticipated 6 months ago celebrating our graduation like this. I have to engage in at least a little bit of uncomfortable laughter with you all in acknowledgement of the fact that we are actually living in the upside down. I have to say as well that giving a graduation speech, what in the last few years has been a reflective and joyous experience, has been one of the more difficult things I've had to do in the last 6 months. I asked myself, what could I possibly say to the class of 2020, a group of young people that is justifiably brimming with a combination of exhaustion and righteous anger and outright confusion? I cannot tell you why someone would instruct you to ingest disinfectant or put a light bulb in your mouth. I can offer no suggestion on whether or not wearing pajamas for hundreds of days in a row is perilous for your health. I'm afraid to admit that I cannot, either as a human or as your school principal, make sense of this senselessness. What I instead hope to do in the last few minutes with you as students is to reflect back some of the things that you have given this community, things that you have also given me in the last 4 years. And I do so with the hope that being reminded of your own greatness will help you carry some perspective forward. When I refer to your greatness, I'm not referring to your accomplishments, although they are many. I could, of course, talk about the fact that you're in the class with the first two national merit finalists, or that the women's basketball team has won back-to-back league championships over the last 4 years. You all are certainly a highly decorated group, but your greatness does not lie so much with your accomplishments. Your greatness lies in your overwhelming ability to be humane, to care for one another and your community in a way that has set the standard for what we might only dream about in a school. You've done it as senior mentors, welcoming and loving the next generation into our community. You've done it as advocates for one another when someone has been the clear victim of injustice. You've done it as essential workers, eager to show care for your family and your community. You've done it in protest, showing up for Black Lives, undocumented folks, or Earth. You've done it as a pride, willing to accept a one-time group of strangers in your life. Not only this, but to choose to love on them for their unique and at times, in Jones pride, very strange qualities. At a time when we have so sorely lacked humane leadership, you have been a reminder of better things to come. Whether you've known it all along or just hearing it for the first time, know this. In normal times, class of 2020, you all have been the source of unbridled joy and admiration for your good works at Kip King. In difficult times, you have been the greatest source of inspiration. You have been a reminder to every adult, every student in this community that they're working towards something greater and that there is a reason to be hopeful when there is none. For that gift, for the gift of humanity that you've shown us, we all have reason to be grateful. Of course, you've not done it alone. Your families, your teachers, your pride leader have been incredible models There have been parents like Ms. Perkins, Mrs. Bustamante, Mrs. Ochoa, Ms. Mora, Ms. Hall, Ms. Allen, and so many more who, in addition to giving some of you life, have also given their blood, sweat, tears, dollars, and about 2 tons of tacos, all for your gain. You had an adopted mother in Ms. Ernestina Thompson who once told me, and I quote, "I will cut off my left arm to go to senior retreat with class of 20. To keep her safe, I had to bring her along." You benefited from leaders like Ms. Krause, Ms. Ball, Ms. Malkovich, who were there to coach you, love you, and let's be honest, help us at times make better decisions. Be sure, if you've not done so already, to thank these people too. To close, I would ask all of us to pause just one more time, to center ourselves on our hearts, to feel a moment of collective gratitude, both to be alive and to be alive here together one more time. To the graduates of 2020, no matter what terrible or uncertain future we face, I hope that you remember that it is from this center, the center of your very humanity, that you will always find a way forward. As our school's namesake, Dr. King, once said that to be great requires only a heart full of grace, a soul full of love, for the opportunity to witness all of your soulful love, your hearts full of grace, I will be forever thankful. And I wish you the happy, bright, joyous, and healthy future that each of you deserve and that we all need. Thank you. I'd like to invite up our student speaker next, the only person to have ever beaten me in a dance competition. Bobcat Cabin will not forget. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Ogena Udumezwe.
Good morning, students, family, admin, and staff. First, I would like to thank all of you, from teachers to friends and family, for being in attendance today. You've all had a profound impact on the development of the students that will be graduating today. So I think it's safe to say that I speak on behalf of the graduating class of 2020 in thanking you all for your efforts you've invested in us to this day. I won't claim to know each and every one of you personally, because I don't. But that doesn't make us complete strangers. Maybe we only sat next to each other for 3 weeks in English class, or maybe we only walked past each other once in a while in the hallway and never spoke. But one way or another, our paths have crossed. Although it's had its ups and downs, this school is and always will be a family to me. This building is a home. No, we don't always get along, and God knows we didn't always want to be a part of it, but that doesn't mean we loved it any less. 3 years ago, I was a new student who was completely lost and had no idea what I had coming. Fortunately, I had already known a number of students from AAU basketball, and USERA was one of them. Thankfully, she was the first face I saw when I walked into the office. When she saw me, she charged at me so fast, I saw my life flash before my eyes. I remember telling her, "USERA, why can't you run like this in practice?" She goes, "Well, I was excited to see you. Who gets excited to go to practice?" Well, she had a point. After I got my schedule, she took me outside and started introducing me to everybody. I've never felt so loved in my life, and that was the day I realized that this is my home and I belong here. The staff and administration have been the strongest support system I've had in a very long time, so I knew not to take that for granted. A number of them deserve a special mention. Ms. Ball, Ms. Malkovich, Ms. Hyman, and Ms. Thompson. These four extraordinary women have made my high school journey unforgettable. I've never seen people root for someone as hard as they root for me. Ms. Ball, thank you so much for caring for me like I was one of your own. Ms. Malkovich, thank you for being patient and being able to bring out the goodness in me. Ms. Thompson, you've always been my number one supporter, and you have no idea how grateful I am to have had you as a teacher. She was like my Yoda, always pushing me to make the right decision, to keep pushing no matter what obstacles I may face. Ms. Hyman, thank you for not only believing in me, but for giving me hope. In the beginning of senior year, Ms. Hyman wanted me to join AP Calculus so bad, but I didn't really want to because I just didn't think I could handle it. I told her, I said, Ms. Hyman, this class just isn't for me. She told me, oh, gee, you are way too smart to blow off a class like this. I've seen what you can do when you apply yourself. And after she said that, I felt a sense of hope. I thought to myself, maybe I can do this. The end of the semester came, and I got a B on my final. Ogena Udemezwe got a B on her AP Calculus final. I couldn't even understand what was going on, even if my life depended on it. All I could think to myself was, Ms. Hyman is the GOAT. I want you all to remember this lesson I've been taught. Whenever you hit a rough and challenging patch, which I know we will, always remember to call on the ideals that Kip has instilled in us. Patience, hope, honor, integrity, and strength in diversity. To accept people as they are, no matter what their background may be. And as you continue to move forward, whether you're heading to a two-year or a four-year college, or simply wherever the wind takes you, remember to do so with an open mind and a full heart. Be ready for whatever the world throws at you and keep going, because despite what everyone keeps trying to tell you, you don't need to have all the answers right now. It's probably better if you don't. Life is a learning curve, not a test, so spend however much time you need figuring out what you really want. The world will change you in ways you never expect, but you shouldn't fight it. Let it help you grow. We've been through so much in our years here, so don't let that weigh you down, but let it push you forward and be what helps you make this world a better place. Your next job in life is to figure out where your calling may be. Yes, it's nice to have someone on your team, but the most important thing you can do for yourself is be your own cheerleader. Encourage yourself and give yourself motivation to keep pushing forward even if the world may seem against you. Finally, to the class of 2020, we fought so many battles to get to where we are, and it was worth it. Unfortunately, the war is not over yet. Of course, you will continue to face predicaments, but despite that, don't forget to hold on to your character. So may fate smile upon us as we embark on this new journey. Let's conquer the world, but as the class of 2020 would say it, let's get that bag. And now for our faculty speaker, Ms. Ernestina Thompson.
Graduates, do y'all remember back in 10th grade, a call and response? If I said, I'll go, you say, yes, okay. Today marks the dawning of a new beginning for each and every graduate here. You are trailblazers. You blaze the trail for academic excellence, and as a result, every junior has access to taking AP English language. Shameless AP Lang plug there. As seniors, you have also established the standards and expectations for United Front affinity groups. To this end, you have modeled for students on campus what it means to be an authentic advocate for cultural and personal identity. There are many perks to a life associated with teaching and learning. As I look back on my 3 years spent here at Kip King with the class of 2020, I take pride in knowing where you've been and where you're going. There is no better reward than the knowledge to know you have made a difference. One of the most rewarding is to have a chance to salute students who have demonstrated outstanding promise. The graduation ceremony promotes and praises such potential. It is with great delight that I stand here with you today, graduates of 2020. I'm here for a simple reason. You asked, you voted, you said you wanted to hear from one of your biggest fans or a person who has always been rooting for you in and out of the classroom. These are your words, And in my humble opinion, you are the standard. You are the greatest. You are your own biggest fan. And as a Kip King Collegiate graduate, you're ahead of the curve. Life is full of adversities and the unforeseen, as you class of 2020 know very well. Often these circumstances intimidate us and we think we can't possibly overcome them. Inside you, though, are not only the secrets of life and success, but also a blueprint for the future. You have arrived at this point in your life having already demonstrated your enthusiasm and your initiative. Believe me when I say that students such as you are exactly the people we need in our universities, our government, and our society. You have demonstrated that not only do you have the ability and desire to succeed, to learn, and to take risks, but you also have the character to unapologetically question the status quo, dismantle systems of oppression, and pursue justice for humanity. The graduation ceremony does not exist simply to reward students. It is to celebrate and to encourage you. This is my message to you today. You have done very well. We are all already proud of you, but the most valuable thing you have proven is your resilience and care for others. My last encouragement for you is to take all that you have learned, take the empowerment you have garnered from your teachers, your admin team, your family, to use as a foundation to catapult yourself into your future when you become the encourager, the advocate, the supporter for those you meet, oftentimes that may have less than what you have. As you move into your future, make use of this moment and of this time. Reflect upon rallying cries sounding across your community, this state, and the nation. My call to action is for you to continue to be engaged and to participate. Register to vote. Continue to stand for what is right and true. Now, my dear ones, it is your turn. I and the other staff have so much love for you, class of 2020. Take with you the Kip King experiences, whether from its very beginnings in freshman year seminar and other positive classroom experiences that galvanized you to pursue your ambitions and achieve your goals and ignite the passions of others and uplift the world around you. Most importantly, continue to defy your own expectations. Class of 2020, you are the standard of excellence. You are unequivocally the greatest of all time. Much love.
Graduates, if you are ready to join the thousands of alumni who have come before you, who have gone on into their community and into the world to serve with wisdom, justice, courage, and humanity, I ask that you please take your tassel in your right hand and together move it from right to left, signifying the crossing from student to alumni. Congratulations, class of 2020.